So we're here today with Richard Halprin, who is running for 45th District Court. How are you today?
I'm good, thank you. Thank you, Crystal, for having me on. This is Dia. How are you managing with all the craziness that we're dealing with?
Oh, definitely a challenge for sure. Well, thank you for taking the time to do the interview. Can you tell us why you decided to run for judge?
Well, I can tell you that I feel like I've been on a to be doing this for a long time. I've been an attorney for 30 years. I spent my career working in district court and circuit court on felony cases, criminal case, traffic cases, representing small businesses, representing families. I spend most of my days in court, most days in district courts throughout Southeast Michigan, circuit courts, mostly in the Tri-County, sometimes outside of there. All I do is handle cases, watch attorneys interact with judges, watch judges interact. I've been doing it for a long time. In 2000, Judge Gubo and Judge Apple appointed me to be the magistrate at the 45th District Court, which is a part position. So I've been handling cases there regularly for the last 14 years, probably done somewhere between 14,000 cases. We might be over 14,000 cases by now. In that court alone, I've handled somewhere between 20 and 24,000 cases or hearings throughout the southeast part of Michigan over the last 30 years. And so I keep learning every experience, but the more I've done, the more I've found that I'm anticipating what they're going to say, do, rule, how they're going to interact. I know what works. I know what doesn't work. And when it came time for me to start really thinking about the reality that judge would be retiring, I wasn't sure if I wanted to become a politician. That's not my background. My background is as an attorney. My background is as an artist. It's as a writer, as a journalist, all kinds of things, but not in politics. And so I had to really kind of do some soul searching and think, well, do I want to be a politician for a little while? Because when I thought about it, sat back very much about the 45th District Court, and I realized there was not going to be a possible candidate better qualified or more suited to take over that position. And so I decided for this time, I'm going to do the things that political people do and run for a position, which is not a political position. It's a nonpartisan position. You're not really supposed to be involved in politics. You're about people and the law and facts and circumstances and making good decisions. So like I was ready to do this, and that I was the most ready of anybody who could possibly ready for to do it, almost born to do it.
So in your time of working there thus far, what are you most proud of?
I'm sorry, what am I most proud of?
Yes.
The ability that I've had to interact with so many different kinds of people. Our court, the jurisdiction covers Huntington Woods, Oak Park, Pleasant Ridge, and Royal Oak Township. That's the people that are most closely serviced. We have people coming through the court system from every city imaginable, in-state, out-of-state. We get people that have been traveling, and they just chances bring them to our court. It's rich people and people that are less privileged, and working people and professional people. And we've had professional athletes come through, kids, parents who brought their kids to court because maybe their kid did something wrong that they shouldn't have. And I'm able to connect with all of them on an individual basis. And so the single moment I will point to of pride, what I will say is that over the last 14 years, I learned to connect with every kind of person that comes through and run a courtroom where I get calls regularly from staff, from police officers. I will sometimes get stumbled by people that I don't really recognize, but I sort of recognize, and they will say, you had my court last summer, and he did this and that, and you were so kind to him, and you were so patient. It was such a learning experience. Those are the kind of things that make me feel like I'm really cut out for the job that I'm looking for, but and suited for the job that I've been doing as magistrate.
Now, what got you interested in working for the court system to begin with?
I think whenever, well, I guess going back far enough, when I was, I don't remember what year it was, but I was about 14, the movie Injustice for All came out with Al Pacino. and it was a wild, interesting movie, a glimpse into the law, obviously some dramatic licensing, but it caught my eye, caught my attention, and the excitement and the idea of getting involved in some, especially on the criminal side, and the stories that people tell and the stories you get to be a part of and actually try to form the outcome of the stories, that's what got me into it. When I was in law school, I worked for an insurance defense firm. Well, first actually for a personal firm and then an insurance defense firm and then a commercial litigation firm. But the commercial litigation firm aspect that also did criminal law. And I found myself, I kept getting drawn closer and closer to the criminals because the stories were so interesting, the people were so interesting. And since 1991 or so, I've been on my own. I did work for a firm for a little while, either going to court or counseling small businesses on how to avoid going to court, many cases, all kinds of cases, but it almost always is involved going to court, trying to help people out of their trouble.
From an administrative perspective, one of the things that the court systems are dealing with is the COVID-19 crisis. How have you been handling that already, and are you prepared to handle that as a judge?
One of the things that we need to do really over the last several weeks is doing Zoom hearings. And so I've done some courts where I practice regularly and then where I'm familiar with the judges. And I had one say that I went to Monroe 2 weeks ago, but actually I went to my basement 2 weeks ago and did a hearing. And when we were done with the hearing, I stopped. I'm a very curious person. So before or after hearings, I always say to the judges, so what do you think about all this? And so the different judges, how they feel. And for the most part, I've probably spoken with about half of judges in the last 2 weeks or so. I am finding that most of the judges are very comfortable with it. Rackets are smaller because crime is down. And the police are all taking arrest warrants quite as seriously as they were before, based on policy and decisions with the court system. But it is making things a little bit smoother. Courts tend to be very traditional and don't necessarily want to do things that are radical. But since you're forced into radical circumstances, that causes you to rethink the way you do things. So criminal cases can be more problematic with Zoom because there's confrontation rights, people have accusers. People shouldn't really, until they can figure out a genius way of doing it, should not have to do a jury remotely. But the things that are more routine to be embraced, and going forward, I would embrace them, especially with civil cases, because civil lawsuits don't really require attorneys to have to sit around for an hour and a half long docket when they could be doing it in the comfort of their own home or office or car. I've seen that a few times. But if things are accomplished more efficiently, why shouldn't they be?
So you touched on this a little bit already, but one of the things that we're asking everybody is, what kind of a judge will you be? When people come into your courtroom and they leave, what kind of a reputation is going to follow you?
I think the reputation will be fair, empathetic, a good listener, a sense of humor. Again, since I've been doing this for 14 years, I know the type of things that people say about me, and they always point to temper, that I take the role seriously, but I don't take myself too seriously. I try to be a good listener. I try to learn from every experience. And so the courtroom that I want to have is the kind of courtroom where people are going to feel comfortable. Most people come to court just to a doctor, especially if they're not feeling well. They're nervous and they don't know what's going to happen. And so the last thing you want is a judge that's going to make them feel more nervous or have more anxiety. I want a courtroom, and I've had a courtroom for 14 years now, where people can feel that they can be themselves, but of course be respectful of the courthouse. And they're going to get through, not there to make people feel worse. Where ultimately it's a court where you're trying to make people better and missions that won't lead them back to courts again.
So in this race, there are a few people running for just one seat. Why should the voters pick you?
Well, I'll tell you, for a number of reasons, and I'll start off with the premise that to be qualified for a judge, legally, you have to be in practice for 5 years. Other than that, anybody can run for judge. The candidates that are running this race, they all bring something to the table. Tell the voters that I'm the only one that brings everything to the table. Our court covers felonies, mirrors, small claims cases, zoning kinds of ordinances, in general civil cases, which are lawsuits under $25,000. I've handled every one of those cases over and over and over. So I know the law. We all are supposed to know the law. That's kind of a presumption. If you're running for judge, you should have a basic understanding of the law. But you also should have a basic understanding of the kinds of cases that come through. You should have ideally negotiated a contract before, settled a lawsuit, dealt with mediating disputes on civil cases, handled the felonies, the misdemeanors, the civil actions. In my 14 years, I've met law enforcement from the area. I have a working relationship with law enforcement. We're not buddies, but we have a very strong mutual respect for each other. So I speak the language of law enforcement. I speak the language of the clerks in our court. Anybody who comes in is going to have to get trained. The learning for me is going to be much smaller than anybody else that comes in because I know the procedures of that court. I know the public court. I know where we keep the blank files. On holidays and weekends where I have to come in to do the arraignments, the clerk, I am the court reporter, and I am the court. And I've been able to manage all those things on my own for 14 years. So when you select me or you consider me as a judge, the learning curve is going to be very short. And not to say that there's not a learning curve. Judges that have been on the bench for 20 years will recognize there's still a learning curve. There's always a learning curve. People have a big head start and anybody else that comes in. And also, you need to be able to speak language of the people that come through. And I don't mean Latin or Portuguese. I mean where people come from. And one big part of my practice over the years has been representing at-risk youth in the juvenile court. I'm the founder of the Michigan Children's Law Center, one of the founding members. We rep kids that are in foster care, that are abuse and neglect victims. I work with law enforcement on those cases. I work with foster families. I go to the home, and a lot of them are low-income homes, and I see the choices that people have to make to survive. When someone comes in front of me, and I'm a magistrate, they're not a stranger to me. And if I've met a particular person, which mostly I haven't, I understand the circumstances, what happens with people with the cycles of poverty, with generational poverty, generational neglect, generational substance abuse issues. I know the people. I understand them. I empathize with them. I don't have the attitude that somebody might have saying that they might be above it. And so I'm fluent in the language of the many people that come through our court.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
You can go to a couple different places. I have a page, which is Richard Halprin for District Judge. You can also go to my website, which is halprin.com. And if you want more information about me, you could go up to the local police stations, or if you see somebody that's a police, and ask them, what do you think of me? Ask off at the courthouse, what do you think of Halprin? I'd be surprised if you don't hear something that's very positive. The police know me, the staff knows me. You just know me. I won't name names, but I've had plenty of neighbors come through. And if I know a little bit, I don't have any problem making decisions. If I know them a lot, I usually send them to the other courtroom. They're going to be accused of making decisions based on any kind of personal relationship. But I've been in the city 25 years. I've been in the district for about 30, going on 31 years. People know me, ask about me. I don't think you'll hear anything bad.
Great. Well, thank you so much for doing this interview today.
Well, I thank you for the opportunity to be part of it. You know, we are in unprecedented territory with regard to campaigning. And so alternative routes of getting the message to people are certainly welcome. And I thank you for the opportunity.